Hello friends, I am Rajkumar Landge from NB Navle Singhgarh College of Engineering, Solapur. I am working as a assistant professor in Electrical Engineering Department. I having 10 year experience. I completed my M.Tech in Electrical Power System. Hello friends, in the last lecture we have to be study the various formulae. So before starting the problems, you should be remember that all that formulae, and that formulae we have to be already derived, and how it will be come. Also I have to be explaining regarding also that formulae. So I hope that you should be keep in mind that formulae. Before starting that formulae, I suggest also that you should be learn, you should be read carefully that formulae. It is very important before solving the problems. So let's start first problem. So I read that problem. That is nothing but the first problem is the diameter and length of 500 kilowatt, 500 volt, 455 rpm, 6 pole DC generator are 84 centimeter and 35 centimeter respectively. If it is the lap wound with 660 conductor, estimate the specific electric and magnetic loading. So this is our the first problem. So in that first problem, we have to calculating the value of specific electric and magnetic loading. So we already observing that, we already study that specific electric loading, that is the AC is equal to IZ into Z divided by pi D, and specific magnetic loading, that is the B average, is equal to P phi divided by pi dl. So we have to calculating the that values. So from that problem, they have to be given some given data, that is the PA is equal to 500 kilowatt, N is equal to 455 rpm. So note that here the speed is given RPM, that is the revolution per minute. So we have to be required speed in RPS, so that we have to be convert into RPS. For that it should be divided by 60. So small n is equal to capital N divided by 60. Put the value, capital N nothing but the 455 divided by 60, it is equal to 7.42 RPS. So speed in converted into RPS. So Z is equal to 660. The diameter, that is the should be given in the centimeter, that is the 84 centimeter. So it is the converted into meter, that is nothing but the 0.84 meter, and they are also given to the length, that is the 35 centimeter. Again it is converted into meter, that is the 0.35 meter. So in the problem they have to be mentioning that it is the lap wound. Okay, so we have to be already listen that if is the it is the lap wound, the value of P and A should be the same, so that P is equal to A is equal to 6. Okay, it is a for that lap wound, that's why we are taking the value P is equal to A is equal to 6. So solving that problem, take the first step. The first step is that we already know the formula of B average and AC. So B average is equal to P phi divided by pi d l. So B average nothing but the specific magnetic loading. So call this equation number 1. Again, specific electric loading, that is the AC is equal to I z into z divided by pi d. So call this equation number 2. So generated EMF E is equal to, capital E is equal to P phi z n divided by A. So from that formula, just we have to take P phi is equal to, so P phi is equal to E into A divided by z n. So it will become to the above formula, that is the P phi is equal to E into A divided by z n. So that P phi value should be put in the equation number 1. So equation number 1 becomes like that: B average is equal to E into A divided by z n into 1 divided by pi d l. Okay, so simplify that or rearrange of that, that is the B average is equal to E into P divided by pi d l n z. Okay, so system is the lap wound, so that we have to take the value A is equal to P is equal to 6. So the value of A is taken as A 6, or should be keep like that. A is writing the A instead of P. So B average is equal to E into P divided by pi d l n z. Now put the values. So E is equal to 500 into, so P that is a pole, the how much the pole it should be given, that is the 6 divided by pi into, put the value of D, that is nothing but the 0.84 into, put the value of again L, that is the 0.35 into, put the value of N, that is the 7.42, and put the value of Z, that is the 660. So B average, calculate that and then get the value. B average is equal to 0.6635 Weber per meter square. So like that we have to calculate the value of specific magnetic loadings. Okay, now come to the step 2. Step 2 is the calculating the value of specific electric loading. Okay, and that is nothing but the AC is equal to I z into z divided by pi d. So in that we have to calculate the value of I z. Okay, that is not given in that given data. So calculate the value of I z. So for that, calculating the value of I z, first we have to calculate the value of armature current, that is the Ia. So Ia is equal to Pa divided by E into 10 raised to minus 3. So this will be the come from the our basic formula, that is the Pa is equal to E into Ia into 10 raised to minus 3. So from that you have to take the IA is equal to PA divided by E into 10 raised to minus 3. Now put the value. So PA is the 500, E is the 500 and 10 into 10 raised to minus 3. So armature current value should be come 1000 RPMs. Sorry, 1000 ampere. So then it is system is the system is the lap wound. So A is equal to P is equal to 6. So current in each conductor IZ is equal to IA divided by A. Put the value IA, that is the 1000 ampere, and A is a 6, so it will become to IZ 166.66 ampere. So equation 2 becomes like that. Put the values, we have to calculate the value of IZ. So put that IZ value in the equation number 2, and our equation number 2 is the AC is equal to IZ into Z divided by pi D. So put the value IZ 166.66 into what is the value of Z? It's nothing but the 660 divided by pi into D, and D value is the 0.84. so calculate that value, then AC come to 41681.77. so that is the specific electric loadings. Okay, so like that we have to calculate the value of specific magnetic loading and specific electric loadings. Okay, so I hope that you have to understand our first problem. If you are having the any problem, please contact me or ask me. Okay, thank you very much.